الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him. We seek help from Him. We ask forgiveness from Him. We seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, you will never find a guardian to guide him. A bear witness, there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without any partner. A bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. The continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, we still with the ethic of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ethics is taken long, but because it's too many verses. And this is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is open and a door no close, will never close until you about to die. Until you reach the point you're about to die, that's when al-istighfar will close. But al-istighfar is a way to get back to the right path and the way to get us to repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never close his door, al-istighfar. And this opportunity that we seek istighfar and we seek repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. Because this is not only for asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, but this will open doors for rewards. When you ask istighfar, not only your sins will be forgiven, but also you will get benefits other than just your sin will be forgiven. In one of this very well-known surah, short surah, the Quran Kareem called Surah Al-Nasr, the victory, which is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدُ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَابًا. This surah was in the time of opening Mecca. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went through the struggle to invite his people Christ, to only say La ilaha illallah. And within Mecca, he spent over 13 years. And when they did not accept, and he was fighting him back, so he went to Al-Madina alone, just he and his Abu Bakr Siddiq, his companion, and even hiding, because the Quraysh would not even let him alone to go away. He was trying to kill him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him with miracles, and then he came back after 10 years, victorious. He left with only by himself hiding, but he came back with thousands, tens of thousands of people, marching back to Mecca, opening, and his fierce enemies either was killed in the first battle of Badr, and the others even, as soon as they realized this is not a human being message, it's a message for our creator. Like Abu Sufyan, he was hiding in his house, and even as a kind of a Prophet Muhammad gave him, as he would like to be proud of himself, he asked the people, if you want to be safe, you go to your home, if you want to be safe, you go to Abu Sufyan's home, if you want to be safe. So for, and Mecca was opened, and the victory was for the Prophet and his companions, and that moment, this is the highest moment of victory in Islam with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But still, he was humble. He was and he was praising Allah subhanahu wa taala. And Allah subhanahu wa taala asked him to praise him, to ask forgiveness for him, because Allah subhanahu wa taala the most forgiving. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he give exemplary role model to when you are in your best shape, if you are in best manner, always remember to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Always remember to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not claim that victory or that whatever accomplishment that you had to yourself. Like Qarun, who he said, I got all this wealth because of my intelligence. No, always refer all the blessings on you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase your rewards, you will increase your blessings. So Surah Al-Nasr, it's a, if you repeat it, so you remember, whenever you are in any shape, always remember, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sabbih, subhanallah, wa bihamdih, subhanallah al-azim, wa astaghfirullah al-azim, al-lazi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum, wa atubu ilayh, innahu kana tawaba, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted repentance. So keep that in mind, and you will feel content. You will feel that you follow in the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also in the istighfar, the prophets will, and the good people was calling their people to make istighfar all the time, because istighfar is the key for success in this dunya. Istighfar, seeking istighfar is the key for, because you don't know, you can be doing something that you are not aware of that's wrong, but it's the reason that always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you for the things that you know and the things that you don't know. You may be doing something that you don't know, but it is not the way it should be. So by this way, when you seek istighfar, then you will reach the point that you have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your sight. You are Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would repent on you. Surah Hud, verse 1-4, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alif Lam Ra, Kitabun Uhkimat Ayatuhu Thumma Fussilat من لدن حكيم خبير ألا تعبدوا إلا الله إنني لكم منه نذير وبشير وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يمتعكم متاعا حسنا إلى أجل مسمى ويؤت كل ذي فضل فضله وإن تولوا فإني أخاف عليكم عذاب يوم كبير إلى الله مرجعكم وهو على كل شيء قدير. So this is this verse here inviting you to keep in mind whatever level you are in, whatever you're doing, always anistaghfiru rabbakum. Make istighfar for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Astaghfirullah al-azim al-lazi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum wa atubu ilayh. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar more than 70 times a day. So keep that in mind. Whenever also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because when you do istighfar and you ask for repentance, what is going to happen? يُمَتَّعْكُمْ مَتَاعًا حَسَنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you content, because content or pleasure is not only physical matters. Because people may have millions of dollars, but they are not happy, they are not content. You maybe have just enough, but you are content, you are happy with yourself, you are happy with your Lord, you are happy with your community. The content and happiness is not material reason, for material reasons. أَجْرُ مُسَمَّى وَيُؤْتُ كُلُّ ذُو فَضْلٍ فَضْلُهُ وَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ كَبِيرٍ. So Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم warning the people, if you don't do that, if you put your back to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking, then the great punishment awaiting. إلى الله مرجعكم وهو على كل شيء قدير. So because every all of us want to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the most power, the most power on all. The prophets was inviting their peoples to make istighfar. Even in the Quran al-Karim verses stated that even one by one. So in Surah Hud also verse 50 to 52, وإلى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإلى عاد أخاهم هودا قال يا قوم اعبدوا الله ما لكم من إله غيره إن أنتم إلا مفترون يا قوم لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إن أجري إلا على الذي فطرني أفلا تعقلون ويا قوم استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم ولا تتولوا مجرمين. Look what Prophet Ad, Prophet Hud invited his nation Ad, that he told, oh my nation, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the only one, he's the only God, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's no associate with him. You are aggressors. You are not following the right path. He told him that I'm not asking for compensation from you. So my compensation is going to be from rewards is going to be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one who created me. Don't you see the reality? And also ask him for what you have done in the past. Ask Allah subhanahu for forgiveness. To forgive you what you have done, because when you go back to the path of Allah and you ask forgiveness, all your previous sins will be changed to hasanat. ثم توبوا إليه. So and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance. Look what the benefits. What's the benefit of istighfar and tawbah? When you make istighfar, when you make tawbah, what's the benefit? يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويزيدكم قوة إلى قوتكم ولا تتولوا مجرمين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send his blessings on you. يرسل السماء, when the agriculture communities is going to get rain, you're going to get water for their crops, and their food will be plenty. So this is a blessing. When you make istighfar, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have provisions to you. ويزيدكم قوة. And if you are weak, you're going to be strong. Your strength is going to come from making istighfar. Because when you follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're going to have the strength from following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to be powerful from the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you're following Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not going to fear somebody else. Because only you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all your matters. Also in another verse, Surah Hud, also verse 61, وَإِلَى ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحٌ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ هُوَ أَنْشَأَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وَاسْتَعْمَرَكُمْ فِيهَا فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ إِنَّ رَبِّي قَرِيبٌ مُجِيبٌ. Also, Prophet Salih went to his nation Thamud. He called them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again, only him, only no associates, because he's the one who created you. He's the one who made you to live on earth, and you use the blessings and use, because everything on earth is for you, for the humans to use. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had everything dedicated for us. Look, compare yourself to other creations. Look around when you walk and you see animals or insects and things, and look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you higher level. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. Look how you live and how the insects live, or how the animals live, or how every you are. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored you. So thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. Compare yourself to other creations. You'll find yourself preferred. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preferred humans than in other creations. And this is something that you should always think and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. فاستغفروه ثم أجين فاستغفروه ثم توبوا إليه إن ربي قريب مجيب. Seek forgiveness from Allah سبحانه وتعالى and ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى for repentance. إن ربي قريب مجيب. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will accept your seeking forgiveness, will accept your seeking the repentance. This is, you find it always. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doors is open, wide open. No secretaries, no somebody in the way. Whatever you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, directly you're going to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond back to you immediately and will accept you and will welcome you, and even will rush, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rush to you to when you come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for asking for forgiveness. Also, in another verse, that's Surah Hud, also 89 to 90. ويا قوم لا يجرمنكم شقاقي أن يصيبكم مثل ما أصاب قوم نوح أو قوم هود أو قوم صالح وما قوم لوط منكم ببعيد. Look, so the prophet Salih, when he mentioned that to his nation, he gave them examples. He gives them example of previous nations. What happened to them? They've been destroyed because they disobeyed their prophet, because they disobeyed the message to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happened to them is known because they know, they pass by it and they see and they read, they know about it. What happened to Qawm Nuh? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them by having the waters coming from the heaven and from the sky, and water come out from earth, and they drowned. And only the people who went in the ship that survived with him. And Qawm Hud, what happened to Qawm Hud? And Qawm destroyed. And Qawm Salih was destroyed. And Qawm Lut also was destroyed. And all of them, they are known. So why they are not taken? And even look what even now, what happened in front of us, whatever we see. So the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has soldiers. These soldiers could be the wind, could be the water, could be the rain, could be something that no human can face, no human can stand against. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ أَجِينْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Rabbi Rahimun Wadud. So after all this, after all what you do, after all what you did, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will welcome you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always there to receive you with for forgiveness and repentance for what you have done. So أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. So when people see other people doing something wrong, should remind them getting back to the right path or seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This also happened from the Aziz Masr in the Surah Yusuf, when what happened between Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam and the wife of this Aziz, Zulaikha, and they knew the truth that she is the one who was has the wrongdoing with Prophet Yusuf. And what happened? فلما بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فلما رأى قميصه قد من دبر قال إنه من كيدكن إن كيدكن عظيم. So he realized exactly the truth. It's her mistake. يوسف أعرض عن هذا واستغفري لذنبك إنك كنت من الخاطئين. So this is indication that if you see somebody who's doing something wrong, it is a good to remind them with making istighfar, because even in an indirect way. And also Surah Ibrahim verse 10, قالت رسلهم أفي الله شك فاطر السماوات والأرض يدعوكم ليغفر لكم من ذنوبكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى قالوا إن أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا تريدون أن تصدونا عما كان يعبد آباؤنا فأتونا بسلطان مبين. So you do your part. You invite people to make istighfar, but what they're going to do, it's up to them, and it's also it's not on your hand, because you are not going to control people's heart if they come back to the right path or not. But at least you are not going to be doing less than just at least do your part. Ask people to make istighfar. يدعوكم ليغفر لكم من ذنوبكم. So we always remind each other that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all. And when you make da'wah like this and generalize it, when you ask for forgiveness, not only for yourself, not only for your immediate family, but ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all believers, to forgive all Muslims, to forgive, if you make istighfar, if you pray for your son or something, pray for your son and the sons of the Muslims, pray for your dead person in your family, pray for them and the dead Muslims and so on. So generalize your prayer so you get the reward. Also another verse we'll finish with that, which is Surah Nuh, Surah verse 1-7. إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنْ أَنذِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَأْتِيهِمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ قال يا قوم إني لكم نذير مبين أن اعبدوا الله واتقوه وأطيعون يغفر لكم من ذنوبكم ويؤخركم إلى أجل مسمى إن أجل الله إذا جاء لا يؤخر لو كنتم تعلمون. قال ربي إني دعوت قومي ليلا ونهارا فلم يزدهم دعائي إلا فرارا وإني كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا. Prophet Noah alayhi salam is an example of all he spent hundreds of years. He lived closer to 1,000 years and inviting his people. But not many people followed him. So you see, could you imagine? So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how many years? 23 years in his messengerhood. But Prophet Noah spent closer to 1,000 years inviting people. But only a few people responded. And when he did what he can and asking the people to make istighfar and give them all reasons to that reward will happen to them, but he, Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, he gave up and did, and look what the difference between Prophet Nuh and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. When he gave up and he gave the reason, said, رب إني دعوت قومي ليلا ونهارا. I ask my people to day and night. فلم يزدهم دعائي إلا فرارا. Every time I ask him to walk away from me. وإني كلما دعوتهم تغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم. Every time I invite them to forgive them, they put their hands, their fingers in their ears so they can't listen. So look how arrogant his people. واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا. Look, so he gave the reason that he didn't leave anything that he can do to invite them to make istighfar. But look, the result, then he cursed them. He cursed them. Prophet Muhammad cursed them. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ever curse his nation, even when in the most difficult times, when the people was stoning him, when the people was chasing him in from Taif, when he went to invite them, and even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the three angels, angel Jibreel, and the angel of the mountains, and another angel to crush the people in the mountains, to get rid of them completely, right away. Like what happened to other nations. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, maybe there's feelings or their grandchildren or children will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will say la ilaha illallah. Look how merciful Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it was what happened. From this Taif, scholars came, people was inviting people. One of these famous people, his name was Ibn Sirin, his famous scholar, that one of the people on that specific city. So inshallah we'll continue on. This is the sequence, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is very long and very many verses. So inshallah we'll, future khutbah will address more of these verses and hadith inshallah. So qul qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. O Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart and spirit. O Allah, do not let our heart deviate from the truth now that we have been guided. But grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer and of my descendants. Our Lord, accept this prayer. My Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of majesty and honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, our Lord, Lord of all creations. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي للصلاة حي للفلاة. قادة الصلاة قادة الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله إلا الله.
Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك رب ربنا وإليك المصير. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم سمي الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك حمد
الله أكبر
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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك حمد
الله أكبر
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 السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله Thank you.